Father of all flesh, blessed be your name, O Lord, because you are the Father of all spirit. The authority in heaven and on earth belong unto Yeshua, the Lord God that save, the Lord God that deliver. Blessed be your name, O Lord God of heaven and the earth, that came into the midst of mankind. And that is why your name is called Emmanuel. God is with us. This is a mystery to people that are carnal, that they are never in the spirit. They can never understand that Jesus Christ, he is God. He is the express image of the invisible God. The Lord God that came to this world to come and give us example on how to live a holy life, perfect life, successful life. Blessed be the name of your name, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for as many that are watching this clip, that whatever may be the attack on your life, I command those attacks now to backfire in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil marks on your head that is making you to have disappointments, I use the blood of Jesus Christ now to clear them away in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Evil voices of discouragement, cease and die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As many that are involved in one thing or the other that are suffering from loss, from today, let there be transformation in your life and let there be prosperity in the name of Jesus Christ. By the power in the name of Jesus Christ, I decree victory into your life from now. In the name of Jesus, you will not suffer. You will not have problem. You shall not die. Blessed be the name of God that answer prayer more than request. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. We want to continue in our series, Idolatry in Religion. And one of the reasons for this topic is because there are many people that have killed in the name of God. Many claim to know God, but they don't know that they are far away from God. To God be the glory. We are in Islamic religion. It's a religion that many Christians run away from. They don't want to discuss about it. They don't want to talk about it, because they know that some Muslims, they are very aggressive to defend their religion, even to the extent of killing such. And as I told you, I won't talk much about the document that Muslims are using. They are using what is called Quran. They are using what is called Hadith, Tasfir. The Quran is a document that has about 114 chapters. The Muslim believe that it was revealed to Rasulullah, that is Prophet Muhammad, for the space of like 22 to 23 years. Quran has a root word from what is called Ikra. That is the first commandment given to that Prophet Muhammad. Ikra means recitation. And it was believed by them that the Malaika, that is angel, that brought those recitations to their prophet is called Malaika Jibril. And when they want to interpret it or translate it to English, some people believe that that is angel Gabriel. But to God be the glory, the characteristics of angel Gabriel in the Bible is different from the characteristics of Malaika Jibril in the Quran, because the way he gives his revelation to the prophet is different from the way he always appears in the Bible. Most of the time, he can press the prophet down as if he wants to seize his breath, and he can at times force him most of the time. So, but that is not the area we are going. It is a document that has what is called Surah and Ayat, that is chapter and verses. And there are two types of revelation in that document. Number one, there are some revelation that take place in Makkah. That is, before the exile of the prophet and the ulamas. There is another revelation that took place in Yathrib that later became Medina al-Nabiyyi, that is the city of the prophet. The one that the prophet received in Mecca, a very, very nice one. The one that has a lot of things to really minister to people, like appealing to them. That is the area you will see there is no compulsion in religion. That is the area you will see that if you kill a person, it's like killing the whole human being. If you not save a person, it's like saving a human being. But when he got to Yathrib, that is Medina al-Nabiyyi, a lot of revelation there are more militant. A lot of laws that there's some part of it that brought about hatred for the people of the book. Who are the people of the book? That is the Christian and the Jew. That is to say, all other religions are no longer tolerated except the religion of people that believe in Allah. All other people that do not believe in Allah, they are called the Kafiri. And Kafiri must not live in the midst of the faithful. Any Kafiri that will live in the midst of the faithful will be paying heavy taxes. And at the same time, that person must not share his faith with another Muslim. If he try that or say anything contrary to what the Quran stipulates, that person may face law and that person can be guilty of blasphemy. Before we go further to hadith is all about the explanation of what really takes place in the life of Prophet Muhammad. That is to say, his tradition and his deed. There are many hadiths, but the one that is majorly and mostly acceptable unto many Muslims are the Sahih Bukhari hadiths. A lot of Muslims refer to this one as authentic, but there are many hadiths. But before we still go further to Safri, Tasfi, and many other documents, I just want to say this, and in appealing even to as many that are watching me, in appealing to Christians, in appealing to Muslims. Religion is supposed to be tolerated. A lot of documents that we are reading now, they are never written in our own time. They are ancient books. Quran was written in a dialect of the Quraysh family. You see, what Christians call as fashion, that is, we have all this King James fashion, New International fashion, and all those things. There are some things like that too in Quran as translation. But they don't want to see it as fashion. They always see it as dialect. That is, different dialect that translates from Arabic to some other language. But that is not where we are going. Where we are going is this. The setting of when they wrote all those documents is different from the setting now. And a lot of things has been outdated. Any religion that is still forcing people to obey the law of the past that are outdated, and that if people don't want to follow it, those people will be killed. One need to be reasonable. Killing people, forcing people to accept Islam, we see anyone doing it like that as an idol worshiper. Killing people, if anybody talk against God or talk against Allah, and you are killing such people, Allah can defend himself if he is God. If God of the Christian is God, he can defend himself. If somebody comes to the church now and tear Bible and abuse Jesus, nothing concerns the Christian. If Jesus is Lord, he can defend himself. If Allah is God, he's supposed to be able to defend himself. A lot of insurgents group that has formed worldwide, killing different people in the name of religion, raping women in the name of religion, that must be stopped. And I want to appeal to every Christian, whenever you see any Muslim, even by name, pray for them so that their eyes will open. That killing in the name of religion will never take anyone to Al-Jannah. It's only when I have an encounter with Jesus Christ the love of God to mankind, then that person can inherit the eternal life. What is happening in Afghanistan, what is happening in Saudi Arabia and Yemen, what is happening in northern Nigeria, we need to really intercede on behalf of these people. God bless you. We continue from this place next week in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.